So thank you for all of you just coming to celebrate this week of trouble. And thank you, Wyatt, for giving me the honor to be Chris Manning instead of Armando. For those that don't know who I am, I'm Ren Bagley. Me and Wyatt, we met in the year 2000. I've known Wyatt for about 22 years now, and I guess you could say he's like a brother to me. So just about me and Wyatt's history. Growing up, Wyatt has highs and lows. You know, when people saw the two of us and connected the dots that we are in fact brothers, they were simply kind of surprised. Because when you look at the two of us, we don't look very similar. They'd ask questions and make comments about the two of us. My favorite one being, oh, so you're older than me. Yeah. Then, but you're shorter than me. I'm catching up. Can you beat him up? Maybe. He's so ugly. Yeah. I'm not an author. I can't write to save my life, but I'll do my best. I'm also not going to give the eye-watering speeches, but if you want that, I'll just give Wyatt a quick sniff, and that should do the trick.
Golly, roasted him.
So instead, I'm off to share some stories with y'all today, and I'll let them speak for themselves. Some might be questionable, but all I do hold is close to my heart. Growing up with three brothers has given me the gift of many stories, and I look forward to telling them to my future family about how the Bagley brothers grew up. Wyatt is in most of the stories. As for my two other brothers, Sarah and Ethan, they're usually the victims of what Wyatt and I would call character development sessions. Yeah. With only four brothers, it was possible for two teams of two, me and Wyatt being on the same team. A long time ago, my dad bought a chicken coop and probably had a dozen chickens or so. It wasn't clean, but probably one time, and it smelled terrible. In the summer, our parents would tell us about video games to go play outside with our brothers. Sometimes those orders had unintended consequences that my parents couldn't foresee. On one hot and humid summer day, Wyatt and I decided to have a character development session with our much smaller, weaker little brothers who were at the mercy of their superiors. Wyatt and I forced them into the chicken coop and locked the door, leaving them to incubate inside the coop, and then proceeded to bang on the walls with our fists and rocks. I don't know how long we left them in there, but no, me and Wyatt was by 20 minutes. It wasn't until recently that I discovered that the fumes emit from the chicken coop is toxic, neurotoxic. So sorry, Ethan, if your grades ever slip, you can use that as an excuse. You're welcome. Me and Wyatt were big movie directors back in our day. We used to make little movies all the time and show our parents. One of these videos consists of us tying up our little brothers into a post and proceed with them with our dad force whip. I'm sure there's a story to it, but we just want an excuse to hit each other. It looked very much similar to one of those terrorist videos with a shaky camera and terrible orders and a victim. One day I head downstairs to the bathroom with Wyatt's video recorder ready for action. I was lucky enough to hide him long enough for Wyatt to walk in to use the restroom for number two. After about a minute or two, Wyatt spotted a little red dot blinking in the back of the door. He proceeded to yell and get furious, but paralyzed in a spot of rest. This is my moment of escape, and I ran out the bathroom and outside. A few short minutes later, Wyatt ran out, and the hunt was on. As I was trekking through the woods, careful to avoid Wyatt finding me, I ran to Ethan. I told him what I did and showed him the video, he thought it was funny. The two of us were eventually spotted, which led to about a mile-long chase through the woods. You know that saying how it's nice to have a fat friend with you in case the bear chases you down so that the bear gets the fat friend instead of you? Well, in this case, it was convenient to have a little brother being chased by a bear. Ethan soon fell into the flesh of Wyatt, and Wyatt proceeded to pummel him as I made my escape. Not only is Wyatt a very emotionally intelligent person, hoping to build up his character, but he's also very smart. In fact, one day he came to the realization that we all have centaurs. In the very same discussion, our family learned that Wyatt is very well versed in scripture and is quite the theologian. My favorite sermon of his was when he made a speech about how our bodies are a pyramid and not in fact a temple. Other times when me and him would tell our mother something we did or she found us doing something we were supposed to be doing, she would visibly get upset at us. But don't worry, we had this master backup plan for contingencies such as this. But Dad told us we could do it, or Dad was with us.
Hey.
Our mother's gaze would turn to our father, and our father's gaze would look at us with betrayal. But the blame now shifted to our father, and he called it mission success and retreated. I wish I could tell y'all more stories about our adventures. You know, even though Wyatt is my little brother by age, it's weird. It's weird because there wasn't a time in my life that I remember that he wasn't there. We're only a year apart, and so once my memory started to form, he was there from the start. Me and him against the world from day one. He's a very dependable man. Ever since we were kids, I've always been able to lean on him when I need support. And when we were kids at a water park, and two Hispanic kids punched me, I immediately went to go get Wyatt. We found them, and unbeknownst to people enjoying the whirlpool, the water slides, and Lady River, a battle ensued under the waters below. He's always the guy I can call if I ever had car troubles, from changing cylinders, picking up on the side of the road at 2 a.m. because I thought my car broke down, but I actually just ran out of gas. Whatever it is, he has never complained. He doesn't expect any kind of comeback. He just genuinely likes to help someone in need. His passion for the Lord is admirable. I've seen it firsthand by not only how he acts, but by also his words that come out of his mouth when we talk about God in a parking lot. His desire to serve his wife by being her protector and provider is shown by the countless hours of work he puts in each week to secure the future together. His integrity and natural discipline will continue to grow in him to be spiritually that he wants to be. Mr. Smith, I'm not a father, but if I was, why has the kind of qualities that makes him a suitable partner for anyone's little girl? Just pray he doesn't pass on his plan and starts to head to your grandkids. I'm Gerald, you are kind, smart, patient, and show the utmost love to my brother. You are going to be a great lifelong partner of my little brother. Thank you for your sacrifice. You truly bring him joy. I only ask that you keep making those delicious meals that I see on Instagram so that you'll fatten up and so that Ethan might be able to outrun the bear next time. Not many people know this about me, but I'm a very sensitive person, and I'm so serious when I say that. That I cherish the moments that, the memories that I've made with you, and look forward to being born. I love you, Wyatt. Welcome to the family, my gentleman.